soul. There's where I'm headed for. Got the stars to guide my way. Sail on into the light of day. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands. It'll be a fair curve.
And I'm afraid that leaves me out.
So Jack fights with his hand. I will play some Joe music.
Okay.
Yes. Enjoy.
So I've been playing classical guitar a lot for the last about 6 months. I had a really, really wonderful classical guitar for a while. It was way out of my depth. It was much too wonderful a thing for me. To the most amazing guitar player who I'd ever run into in London, and he broke it. And there's a YouTube video of him talking about having gotten another one and having broken mine, but he never called me to tell me that he broke mine. Which is really too bad. He knew the person who made it, which is pretty amazing. But last summer, I went into a music store to get a guitar string, and there was somebody playing an electric guitar in the back. And I went over to see it because it sounded like such a weird guitar. And as I got there, he stood up handing me the guitar, like, okay, your turn. And I sat down and I played it for about 30 seconds or 45 seconds, and I was already scanning the wall looking for where to hang it because it was so clearly not my guitar. And all these plastic guitars hang on the wall that all get their polyurethane finish sprayed on them and buffed out. There was a guitar that jumped out at me because it was French polish and it was old. French polish is something you do with shellac and linseed oil and a teeny bit of tongue glue and rub it into the wood. And I picked it off the rack and I took it down and I started playing it. And I was supposed to be getting dinner. I was on my way to the store to get dinner. It was 2 hours later. I finally went up to the cash register and tried to put it on my credit card. Because nobody carries that kind of money right out of their pocket. And their computer was down. And they couldn't run my credit card. And I came back the next day. And they had promised they'd have their credit card machine running. And they actually didn't. But they had Square running. So I got this guitar that was made in 1963 in Seattle, really in Olympia, by a guitar maker who was sort of the first guy in the Northwest to start making classical guitars. And this is his 15th or 16th guitar. And he ended up sort of taking over that part of Evergreen whenever Reid started making guitars and teaching kids to make guitars down there. And if I'm really, really lucky, he's only about 10 years older than me, and maybe he's still alive, because it would really be cool to show him this guitar that he made that long ago, because it totally woke up. So I've been playing classic guitar now. Instead of this, it's like I only play this guitar now playing with jazz. And I play this guitar that has a much wider fingerboard and a completely different flavor. So everything I play is sort of, I don't know how to describe it, but it doesn't fit well on this guitar at the moment. But that's okay, because there's stuff that does fit on this guitar. That's kind of the official Joe trademark thing that I've been playing for a really long time. And then there's this other one that I was playing earlier this evening. That this is sort of the evolution of that thing. It took me into, I got a guitar that was made in Venezuela up in the mountains. In this, I found it because it's got a name inside it. I found it on Google Earth. It's sort of like Lilywop. It's got a highway that's like a one-lane road going through it. And it's got two cross streets and one back street. And the person who made it clearly had plans of some sort for a guitar or some vision of how it worked, because it's a copy of a classical guitar from around the turn of the 19th to 20th century. It's pretty much got, you know, the fan bracing and the arrangement, everything is correct, but the material that it's made out of is clearly mostly cut with a handsaw from a pallet, and the top is clearly made from an apple crate that came from up here, because it's spruce, but instead of having the top be split and joined in the middle and bookmatched like this in vertical grain wood, it's flat sawn spruce, like the side of an apple crate, and then the seams are here and here, exactly the width of the side of the apple crate, and then the wings are glued on there, cut from the other side of the apple crate. And it's got a place on the back, right here where the neck joins it, that feels like the small of your back, where the coccyx and the, it feels like a person.
And scary.
And it has this great story. Joni Fabian, lots of you people probably know. Joni cleans up messes that people leave behind when they die unexpectedly. And so she was cleaning up a mess from a soldier of fortune person who has this really interesting gig of going to Cuba. He used to know Raul Castro. He travels around South America, and when Royal Enfield motorcycles that belong to police departments crash, he parts them out because there are parts that they need in Cuba to keep their fleet of old motorcycles running. So that's his gig. I mean, he has other gigs because he's a smuggler and he does all this other stuff. And there were two guitars in his stash down at Lake Cleveland. And one of them was a Martin 12 string. It was really easy to put a price on that and value on that and sell it. And this other one, Joey kept calling me or badgering me in interesting ways and saying, there's this interesting guitar and it needs to know how much it's worth and needs to know how much it'll cost to fix it. Because it's got cracks and all sorts of problems. And so it finally caught up with me at Farmer's Market one day. And it had 30 seconds in my lap before I said, Joni, we've been having entirely the wrong set of questions about this guitar. The question was simply, how much cash do I have to give the people who own this guitar so they will never feel like they got taken? Because my job is to make sure nobody ever tries to fix it. Because it's already perfect. And it's like the guitar in Black Orpheus. The frets are completely randomly spaced. Like this fret is way farther apart than this one. And the way guitar scales normally work is mathematical, and it's like the 12th root of 2. And you know, there's a formula that generates this one. It's just randomly sawed in there because it looked right. And so it doesn't play the same scale as other guitars do. It doesn't play the same music as other guitars do. So there's a warp and then a twist in the neck that's about 15 degrees. So the head is twisted like this. But that really doesn't matter because they're all, the strings are in a plane. So everything about it is completely nuts and different and unique. And it taught me chords. It's teaching me music that I never would have played. I mean, I've been playing for 60 years now, and I haven't found any of these chords yet.
Seems to be better. I gave it an extra glass of water and a good shot of energy, and we'll see how it does. We've got a couple more songs in us tonight before we go home, but
I'm told.